So, our next speaker is Professor Maciej Kataka from Czech Republic. He's Deputy President of the Czech Association of Photocatalysis. He's CEO of Nanotech System, and he's still working at the university. So please.
Okay, thank you very much, Nick. And first of all, congratulations. You made an excellent job that you brought so many people together and we can discuss.
In the finalization of my talk, I will have of course some proposal how to continue such sessions. Thank you for the introduction. As you heard, I have several faces, and maybe you are surprised with this nanotech system, and that we established such a high-tech oriented company. But the reason is my discussion with Professor Fujishima something like 20 years ago, because he explained to me that if you are involved in applied science, you need to see your results of your research to be realized in the real world. If not, something was wrong, and you did a very good job. It means, in the end, I would say, in the end of my career, before I leave this world, I really like to see our results in the real world. And with colleagues and with good friends, we decided to establish this company jointly with some visionaries, company, and we look to nanotech system as a company which is source of know-how, because we were pioneering this application field in Europe, and source of know-how on the field of photocatalysis and nanomaterials, and we like to apply our research results as soon as possible, and we also like to guarantee function by standard testing and certificates. It means we need to be focused. We cannot do everything together. And nowadays we have three priorities. We like to apply that photoactive material technology to buildings that are attacked by algae and fungi, to concrete construction and historical monuments, which is my private challenge. As you know, this is not only in Prague, Praha suburb, but in many places such an ugly looking panel houses, small towns are surrounded, they are usually on the suburb of the cities, and nowadays those houses, they go, we call it process of revitalization. What does it mean? Everyone like to have nice houses, and also we need to save energy. It means such houses, they go to for additional insulation. It doesn't work. It means, but what will happen? If you do additional insulation of the houses, you change the parameter. Air breathing is very different, and as a result, houses are looking even more ugly, because soon algae, different type of algae is growing, and also algae is not so dangerous, but usually also different type of fungi. To understand, of course we cannot do everything by ourselves. We do quite a lot of research together with experts on algae and microorganisms, and especially we are closely cooperating with microbiological laboratories in Nanotechnology Center. I am also a member of Technical University of Liberec and also other research institute in Praha. It means, first, when I joined this Institute of Nanomaterials of Technical of Liberec, I my task was to start a photocatalytic field in that technical university, and no one believed that such a technology or coating can purify air or to keep clean facade. And to convince the director of that institute, I did some very simple trial. I was just coating every second stream, like you see here. And after 2 months, the effect was very, very evident, because in the front of that entrance to that nanotechnology center, many cars are usually parking. It means it was very, very convincing. How we proceed? We start this photocatalytic coating business as a prevention of algae and fungi growing. First, we took the sample of the buildings. Our microbiological center is doing complete analysis of what type of algae, what type of fungi. Of course, we need to measure the light intensity on the field. We need to collect data, how much light is during spring time and summer time, and so on. And after that, we make the decision if our technology is effective or suitable for very concrete building house which is waiting to be treated. Because to mention what is another solution? If you have such an ugly looking green house, you only solution which is offered by another companies like in Europe, it's a very famous Weber company. Those companies are using chemicals to remove and to make protection. But those chemicals are not so well acceptable by nature environment, because they are washed away, and the lifetime is limited usually for 5 years. We offer the longer life, we can convince the market, and it's also very ecological technology. Of course, we are not manufacturing that coating, photocatalytic coating system by ourselves. Our partner for this application is leading Czech paint and coating manufacturer. I think it's number one in our country, is Barvilaki Telluria company. It means how it's done. First, you need to wash away that algae and fungi, and after that that photoactive coatings is applied by all possible means. It means by regular coating, or it can make by climbers, or you can make as a construction, or you can apply also by spraying system. And there are some examples how it's done. On the left side is that still polluted house. On the right side is how it looks like after treatment. You can see several. Example. And now, as I mentioned, because we call our lecture, it is some contribution to improving environment condition in Praha city. And, I think several of you, or many of you, visited Praha, and in Praha you find not only Charles Bridge and some famous buildings, starting with Roman and Gothic and other style, but there are many plastic, many statues, and they are also, by changing environment, they are becoming green, green, and they are waiting for reconstruction. And it's really a long time process. I've been involved in this possible potential application, perhaps 10 years, because first you need to convince conservators, they are very conservative, yeah, that our techniques, our technology is not destroying those monuments, but it's really helping. And during discussion with conservators, you understand they have such a belief that the final surface of such a statues must be hydrophobic. Yeah. But this is wrong. Yeah. If the final surface is hydrophobic, you create good condition, algae and fungi alike. Yeah. It means opposite. Photocatalytic coating makes advantage doing the final surface even hydrophilic. Yeah. And to convince myself that it's really working, I made some trial even on the coated pattern. Yeah. This is in our garden, and I coated just only part of it, and after 1 week of sunny weather, I myself was really convinced that this technology is effective and it's really working. Yeah. It means by convincing the city of Praha, the gallery of Praha, finally we got approval to start trial to coat 10 such a statue like on the left side. We have free access to depository, exterior depository of gallery of Praha. We can test our coating system, we can work together with conservators, and of course we parallel are also working in laboratory. And we hope that our trial this spring will be successful, and we get the green light for next period of time. And there are 100 such a plastic they are waiting for to be prepared. When Professor Fujishima talked to you, he just explained that he's still keeping black hair. If you look to that picture, it's taken 20 years ago in Praha.
White.
But he's still his black hair. And I was understanding what is the reason behind. Perhaps the reason behind is his self-coated host. He was his inspiration, and I make always joke with him that he must wake up every morning very early and to clean his house to show the visitors that photocatalytic technology is still working. He's working manually perhaps instead of becoming fit. Just as I explained that I have several faces, we try to contribute something, and we were running this project from 2006-2009. And we succeeded to bring many European researchers together. We were running this project with Detlef Bahnemann, and the results of this project, one of the results was establishing a technical committee to design European standard on photocatalytic field. It means they are not only ISO standards, but only European standards. And, just 4 years ago, or 3 years ago, we organized in Praha related ISO technical committee meeting, a conference which was called Standardization and Certification Assisting Commercialization, because we believe that this certification is extremely important to distinguish which technology and which type of products are really good and working. This is also my favorite topic, that what are limits of photocatalytic air purification, and of course course, there is no doubt that you can remove by photocatalytic the surface NOx, but you need also to understand the limits, and after that to understand when is really sensible to apply and where not. And I also mentioned in my question or comments to Professor Fujishima that we already introduced the Czech association certificate, which we are offering to all other European associations working on photocatalysis or researchers, to understand what possible limits are important, that you can say that this material or technology is really working. And thank you very much for your attention, and to stay here. We have such an idea that next year we may organize some similar session, which will be devoted not to just only NOx purification, but how to protect nature monuments through the Europe, and if this photocatalytic technology is acceptable. We are almost convinced that it's really helpful. Thank you very much.